a saying, man proposes, but God disposes. And we see this so clearly in the life of David. Here he is, the despotic king with his monarchy and his harem, obtaining wives, and the future kings, the successor kings in his harem. David acts in some ways like you would expect in that historical period. But you see, he's proposing one thing, you know, with Michal, the daughter of Saul, and with the wife of Nabal, you know, it means fool. He's taking these women into his harem. But you see, he's proposing, but God is disposing. It's God. God, let me tell you something. God will get his way, one way or the other, regardless of you. He will get his way. And what was God's way? Well, if you look at 2 Samuel chapter 5, verse 14, and you compare that with 1 Chronicles 3, 5, you will see that with Bathsheba in Jerusalem, there are two very important sons that were born, Nathan and Shlomo. Now, we're talking about Miriam, but Natan bat Dovid. We're talking about the genealogy of the mother of Mashiach. In Luke chapter 3, you see his name there as well. Then you see Shlomo. You see his name in Matthew chapter 1 as well, because it is Joseph ben Shlomo ben Dovid. And you see, God was getting ready to bring the ben Dovid Savior, the Mashiach. He's getting ready to bring him on the scene, to be born in Beit Lechem, to fulfill the prophecies, to make the Kippurah, to die, to be buried, as it says in Isaiah chapter 53, and to stand up alive. And so God disposes. God brings his will to pass. Now I'm asking you today, you may look at your life and say, oh, look at all this chaos, all these problems, a divorce, an abortion, this happened, that happened, children won't speak to me, this is going on, that's going on. Okay, but you know what? Look at David's life. He had a lot of chaos as well, and some sin, some big sin. But yet, nevertheless, God still worked in his life because his heart was like God's heart. He had a heart after God. Do you have a heart after God today? Will you, the Mashiach ben Dovid, he's standing at the door of your heart right now. He's got his mile knife. He wants to circumcise that heathen, pagan way, that profane thing in you. He wants to give you a Jewish heart. Will you bow your head right now and let the ben Dovid with his mile knife cut away the Yetzer Hara right now? Pray this with me. God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, come into my heart. Mashiach ben Dovid, forgive my sins, take control of my life, ascend the throne of my life as my Kippurah, my Savior, and Adon Kol Haaretz, and I'll give you all the praise. And everyone said,
amen.